Here in this example, we are going to see that how the programming can be done using this output latch and output unlatch instruction with this particular operation. So this process is a one where we are going to control the level of the water inside this water tank by turning on and off the discharge pump, which is located at the bottom of the storage tank. By the four input devices, which are the one is on and off switch, and the other one is manual and automatic switch, and the other two switches are the sensors which are connected at top and bottom of the storage tank, where at the top, which is high sensor switch, and at the bottom, the low sensor switch. So when the water level reaches at the sensors, these sensors will be closed. But at initially, these sensor switch will be opened, and apart from this, we have other three output devices, which are the indicating lamps. The one is the pump running indication, and the low level indication, and the high level indication. So here is the process. How we are going to do is, when we keep this in manual mode, we can manually turn on and off this motor. When we can turn on the motor means, when the water level is at any level except at the low level, so the motor should not be turned on when the water is reached at this low level, but it can be turned on at any level of water in manual mode. And when we keep this in automatic mode, so this motor can be turned on when the water level reaches at this high, and then it should be turned off when the water level reaches low automatically. And this on off switch is provided to turn on the motor and turn off the motor. Like that, we are going to use a PLC ladder programming to do this operation with the help of output latch and unlatch instruction, and the other basic instruction like XMN if open, XMN if close, and output energize, OTE instructions. And now we will go with the simulator and we will see how the programming can be done. Okay, here is a simulator. In this simulator, we have the input rack and output rack here. We'll use these four input and these four outputs. So the first one, this input, which is connected to the terminal 0, we'll use it as an on and off switch. And for the terminal 1 here, the switch is connected. I'll use it as manual and automatic. And this terminal 2, this switch, I'll use it as a low level sensor switch. And then this terminal 3, I'll use it as a high level sensor switch. And then, and in the output, I'll use this this output terminal 0 as an motor output, means the motor starter coil. And this is an indication where we're going to provide this indication in a green color to represent the motor is running. And in this one, terminal 2, which indicates the water is at low level, and this terminal 3, which is to indicate water is at high level, which is yellow in color. So these are the lamps which indicates that particular output is on. When they are glowing, it indicates that those outputs are turned on. So now we will go with the programming. In the first rung, I'll write a manual mode where we're going to use a bit instructions. So for that, first I'll check with the whether the particular process in manual or in automatic. So once the switch is open, it means the motor is in off position, and when the switch is closed, that indicates the motor is, the process is going to start. Okay, when this is in open condition, it represents it is in manual, and when we close this switch, it indicates that it is in automatic mode. Like that, we are going to do the programming. For that, I am going to use XMN if close instruction in this rung for manual and automatic checking. So this rung will indicate, this rung will be used for the manual operation, means XMN if open. Thing is, if the switch is open, the condition should be true. Like that, we are going to use it for manual. And then after that, in the manual mode of operation, the motor should be started except at low. Means the initially this the low level sensor switch will be opened, means that when the water is reached at the low level, the sensors which will be closed. When some water is at the low level, sensors that will be closed. We are going to use examine if closed instruction for this low level indication, and after that one more instruction that we are going to use it, examine if closed for on off control here. So this switch will be like, if you open the switch, so that will be opened here, and then if you close the switch, and this instruction will be true, and then we can turn on the motor in manual mode. And then the same thing, we are going to use it in automatic mode. In the parallel with, we are going to use it in OR logic. For that, we will use a branch instruction here, and now we will place these two instruction inside this branch, and outside this branch we are going to place this on off control. Now I will use these two instruction here, and in this branch instruction we are going to place it for automatic operation. In this automatic operation we are going to place, once we close this switch, that means an automatic operation, that automatic instruction should be true. For that I am going to use this examine if closed instruction here, and then after that once the sensor switch is opened, so we need to discharge completely until it reaches the low level. For that, to hold something value, we are going to use a latch or unlatch. For that I am going to use one more instruction, which is examine if closed instruction in series with this manual or automatic instruction. Okay, and after that an output energize instruction is given to this. It indicates motor should be turned on or off depending on these conditions. Okay, so this gives a motor control, when to turn on the motor and when to turn off the motor. In this particular first branch here, the motor will be operated in manual mode, and in this branch the motor will be operated in automatic mode. After that we need to do the programming for latch, and how to latch this means the output should be in a hold position where we need to complete or continuously run the motor until it reaches the low position, even after opening the high sensor switch. For that I'm going to check with the condition that the particular switch is in automatic mode. For that I'll use this examine if close instruction, because once we close this switch the process will be in automatic. So that I'm going to use this instruction, and then we'll check with the condition that whenever the high sensor switch is closed, that latch instruction should be energized, means the motor should start. For that I'm going to use this output latch here. This is an output latch instruction, and then after that we need to use an unlatch. If you are using a latch instruction, we have to use an unlatch instruction, which should be addressed same. Later we will see that how we can do the addressing for these programming. So now I'll, in the another rung, I'm going to use an unlatch instruction where we have to use a two branches. Means in an automatic mode, the output should be unlatched when the water level reaches to the low level. And if we keep the process in manual mode, again the output should be unlatched. So that we have to check with those two conditions. And for that I'm going to use this examine if close instruction for automatic and manual, since if we keep that in automatic mode, and with the another condition that when the low level sensor switch is opened, at that time output unlatch should be energized, so that this can be used. In other cases, if we are going to use the branch instruction for the manual control, we can check the condition that in this case we are going to use this examine if open instruction to check whether the switch is in manual or automatic. So since if we open this, so that means it is in manual, means that the unlatch instruction is true, so that it will unlatch the output, so that in manually we can control all those outputs. So after this three rungs, the next three rungs will be the indication, where we are going to provide an indication that motor is running, and the indication for low level and the indication for high level. So here we'll use that examine if closed instruction here to indicate that motor is running. For that I'll use this output energize instruction here, and then in the next instruction I'm going to use it for low level indication, where examine if open instruction is used to indicate that when the low level sensor switch is opened, at that time our low level indication should be turned on. For that I'm use this output energize instruction here, and then the other the last rung is the high level indication. For that, when the high level sensor switch closes, at that time our output should be energized. For that we used examine if close instruction. Whenever the high level sensor switch is closed, at that time it indicates that water is full, so that we need to indicate that water is at high level. And now this is all about the programming, and after this we need to give an address for these instructions. So already told you that I'm using these four switches as an input and these four indications as an output. So for this, so this thing is an on off switch. I have to use this on off switch address. I'll place it the address for this instruction to check on and off condition, and then this instruction is a low level indication. So here this terminal 2 is a low level sensor switch, and then this one is a manual or automatic which is connected to terminal 1, and then the output, this zeroth terminal of output is given here, and then this instruction is manual or automatic. So I'll place the address of that manual or automatic switch here, and then this one is a latch or unlatch. For this one we are going to use an internal bit or an internal relay type instruction. For that I'll go to the data table. From the data table I'll use a bit file, which is a binary file, a B3, and I'll use this particular bit to store the status of this instruction. So for that I'll copy this address, and then I'll paste the address here. So now I have done with the addressing of this particular instruction, which is to latch and unlatch the output, which is to hold the motor in on position and to make the motor to go to off position. Like that we have used this internal bit address to store the instruction status. And in the next rung we have this manual or automatic, where the switch is connected to this terminal number 1, and then high level sensor switch, which is this terminal number 3, and then this latch, the same address should be given for this latch here. I have already copied that and then paste the address here, and the unlatch instruction also should get the same address as the latch address got. I'll paste it here, and now in this rung number 2 we have a manual and automatic. This one, the switch which is connected here to this terminal number 1, I'll place the address to here, and then after that this is a low level sensor in switch which is connected to terminal number 2, and then after this one is to indicate that manual or automatic connection. In the case of manual we will give the rung in this way, the logical continuity will be obtained in this way. Okay, when we have keep this, and I'll give the address for this terminal number 1, and now these are all the indications that we need to provide it. So this is the motor connected to the terminal number 0, so that address I'll paste it here, and then the indication will be provided from this indication where the LED is connected to the terminal number 1. I'll paste the address here, and then this in the rung number 4 we have a low level sensor switch which is connected to this terminal number 2. I'll place the address here, and then the LED, which is the indication which is obtained for a low level, is connected to the terminal number 2. Address is placed for the output of that, and then in the next rung we have this high level sensor switch. When the sensors high level sensor switch closes, at that time we need to obtain the output. For that high level sensor switch is connected to terminal number 3. I'll place this address here, and after that this output terminal number 3, which is connected to indicate the output, which is at a high level indication. So now we have done with the addressing of this program. So now we will download this program into the PLC. We're downloading this program, and after downloading the program, keep the PLC in run mode. And now we will check with the different outputs. First we'll go with the manual operation, then we'll go for automatic operation. So in the once we download the program into the PLC and keep the PLC in run mode, since the process is at the beginning, so here the water storage tank is empty. So since the low level sensor switch is open, so now the indication of this lamp is in red color, so that it indicates that water is at low level. So now once we start pouring the water into the tank, so this low level sensor switch will be closed. So now once the switch is closed, that indication will be turned off, because the water is reached at the low level sensor switch and it is closed now, and the water level is rising, and after that it reaches to the high level sensor switch. When the high level sensor switch closes, at that time the indication will be provided to note that it is at high level, means the water is at high level. So here you can see that this particular rung is true, the rung number 5, and the output is energized. So here it is indicating that the water is at full. So in this case we can say that the water level indication, which is high and this is low. So now water level is at high, so we will turn on the motor by closing this switch, means we will on the motor. Now you can see that by turning on the motor, so this is the manual operation. So this instruction is true and these three instructions are true, so the output is energized, means this is switch is kept in manual mode and the low level sensor switch is closed, so that the water is above the low level, so we can turn on the motor. And now this switch is kept on so that the motor can be turned on. So here the indicating that water is at high level and the motor is turned on. So you can see that this terminal number 1, the output terminal number 1 is indicating that is motor is running, and since the motor is running, water is started to discharge. So here the high level sensor switch will be get opened. So even after that the water is going down. So when the water reaches the low level sensor switch, and now this switch will be opened. When the switch is opened, the output will be turned off, which is the motor or the discharge pump will be turned off, and the indication goes off. And now the indication which is glowing with now is the water is at low level, so the motor will be turned off in the case of manual operation. So here now I'll show one more thing in the manual. So here we'll close this low level sensor switch, and then say that the water is at half level, since it is not reached at a high level sensor switch. So high level sensor switch is in open. So even in this case also we can turn on the motor. So as you can see here, the motor is started now, because the motor can be started at any time except at this low level sensor or the low level of the water. So now if we open this low level sensor switch, since the water is completely discharged, so the motor will be turned off, and then indication will be provided that water is at low level. So now we will turn off the motor, and now we'll go for the automatic operation. To go for this automatic operation, we have to keep this switch in closed condition. It represents the motor is closed. So now since we are starting at the beginning, the water is empty in the container of the tank, where low level sensor switch is open and also high level sensor switch is open. So now we will start pouring the water to the tank. Now the switch is closed, means water is started to flow into the tank, and now water is raising it level. So now it reaches high level sensor switch, and high level sensor switch also closes, so it indicates that water is at high level. So now we will start the motor by turning on this pump. So once we keep this switch in closed position, so now you can see that these two indications will glow. So now I'll close this. Now you can see that this particular motor output is energized by this run conditions here. So you can see that the other branch instruction where we have kept that in automatic mode. So this this instruction is true, and now it is energized. And at the same thing, this output is latched. So output is latched means here once we have started the motor, or high level sensor switch will be get opened once that water is started discharging in the tank. So now this switch will be opened. Even after opening this, our output is latched. So now after some time, the water level in the tank will be at low level, means this switch will be get opened. So now what happens, you can see that so the motor is turned off automatically, and the indication which is given here is water is at low level. And as you can see that in this thing here, the output, this particular rung number 4 is energized to indicate that this water level is at low. And here the bit file which is used to unlatch, so that has changed the status of this particular bit files here, and now the motor is turned off. So I'll show you that with respect to the data table, so how the bit file instruction will be changed. Okay, we'll see that bit file status. So this particular bit status will be changed when the output latch and unlatch will be activated. As you can see here, I'll close the low level sensor switch, and then after reaching the high level sensor switch, this will be closed. And now you can see that this particular bit is 1. It represents like that output latch is true, so that this particular bit will be energized. And after that, if we open the switch and then the water level reaches to the low, at that time what happens is you can see that the in the table you can see this bit will be changed to 0 when I open this low level sensor switch. You can see that. So now the motor is stopped, and this bit, the status of this bit is changed to 0 from 1. So from this we can use output latch and unlatch instruction to do the PLC programming, like with the basic PLC programming. So where we are going to use all the bit instruction to control an operation, where we are going to control the discharge pump in an automatic and in other way with a manual mode also.